ओमज्ञानतिमिरन्धस्याज्ञानञ्जनशलाखया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्तस्वामिनिति नामिने नमस्ते सरस्वतीदेवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषा शून्यवादी पाश्चात्यदेशतारिणे जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासदि गौरभक्तवृंद हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्णा हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे सो हियर वी आर सीइंग शौनक Rishi is inquiring about the conversations which happened between Vidura and Maitreya Rishi. So he is saying that when Vidura and met Maitreya Rishi, there must have been many topics which would have been discussed. And these topics, because both of them are great devotees of the Lord, must be in relationship with the Supreme Lord. And these topics which were narrated, they are exactly like the river Ganges. If we bathe in these pastimes of the Lord, narrations of the Lord, pastimes of the Lord, then all the sinful activities, all the sinful reactions will be nullified, just like when we bathe in the river Ganges. So actually this is so important. One is that actually when the devotees meet with each other, rather than samprajalpa, it is always expected that we discuss the pastimes of the Lord, we discuss Krishna Katha, topics related to the Supreme Lord. First we see Vidura and Maitreya Rishi meeting, and Shaunaka Rishi is very excited about what did they discuss, and he is very confident that actually whatever they have discussed is all related to the pastimes of the Lord, because these are the two great devotees of the Lord. This is how this great personality teaches how to be Krishna conscious. Because prajalpa is something which will eat away our devotional service. There are certain things which are not favorable in Krishna consciousness. Prajalpa is compared to something like, just like Prabhupada gives the example, the toad, the frog, unnecessarily croaking. So we all know what happens when the frog makes a lot of sound. It only attracts the attention of sarpa, snake. So similarly, prajalpa takes away our life, because the kala sarpa actually engulfs us. It eats away our life. So devotees must be very careful and learn from these great personalities. So here we are seeing that when Maitreya and Vidura met, Shaunaka Rishi is very excited to know about the different pastimes of the Lord, which would have been narrated when both of them met together. That's what he is saying. Tayoho samvadato suta. Samvadato means when these two personalities, tayoho means Maitreya and Vidura, he is referring to them. Samvadato, when they were conversing with each other, then pravartahi amala kathaha. There arose, pravartaha means it came out, it arose. Just like when we do, when the curds is, you know, churned, or when the milk is churned and the butter comes out, it arises from that. So similarly, when there is a conversation between two great devotees, in that churning, what comes out is Amala Krishna Katha. Not some material subject matter, some topics. So he's saying, Pravartahi Amala Kathaha. And the topics of the Lord, they are completely pure. There is no tinge of material contamination in them. So, that's how he is comparing. He is saying, it is just like Apaha Ganga. It is just like the water of the Ganges. What does it do? Just like the water of the Ganges, if you go and take bath in that, then our sinful reactions, our sinful, whatever different reactions we have got, they will be nullified. We will become purified of sins. Similarly, when we bathe in such kinds of topics of the Lord, Amalaha Katha, then Ivahaga Ghani. That means all our sinful activities will be vanquished, will be finished. So, this is actually the glories of hearing the pastimes of the Lord. In 5th canto, in Srimad Bhagavatam, there is a very beautiful description about a little difference between hearing the pastimes of the Lord, which are also like Ganges, and physically going and taking bath in the Ganges. So there, the inhabitants of Jambudvipa, they are praying to the Lord. It's a very beautiful prayer. So they say, Yat Sanga Labdham Nijavirya Vaibhavam. Nijavirya means the potencies of the Supreme Lord, the influence. Vaibhavam means the influence. Yat Sanga Labdham. The potency which one achieves by associating with the pure devotees of the Lord. Yat Sanga Labdham. Labdham means one attains or one achieves. What is that potency one achieves when one associates with pure devotees of the Lord? So he is saying, this cannot be achieved even by going and taking bath in river Ganga. Tirtham muhuhu. Repeatedly, if you go, muhuhu means again and again, if you go to Tirtha and take bath, samsparshatam, that means you have to be in touch, you have to take bath. Hi manasam, manasam means the dirty things in the mind. Only then you can think that dirty things in the mind will be washed away. When many, many times a person goes and takes bath in river Ganga, but the potency one can achieve just by associating with the pure devotees of the Lord and hearing about the Lord, harati ajoho antaha shruti bhir gato angajam. If he gives oral reception to such association, in the association of such pure devotees, if he gives oral reception, antaha, sorry, shrutu bhir gato, then what happens? Harati antaha angajam. Antaha means in the core of the heart, whatever dirty things may be there, even such things will be wiped away just by hearing Krishna Katha. So they are saying, Kovaina Seveta Mukunda Vikramam. Who is that person after knowing this, that actually just by associating with the Lord, just by associating with the pure devotee and hearing Krishna Katha, it can cleanse the core of my heart? Who is the person who will not take interest? Kovaina Seveta Mukunda Vikramam. Mukunda Vikrama means in the activities of the Lord, who will not give oral reception to them. So very beautiful translation is there, Prabhupada says. By associating with persons for whom the Supreme Personality of Godhead Mukunda is the all in all. So with which kind of persons one has to associate? For a person who has no other shelter than Lord Mukunda, for whom Mukunda is all in all, nothing else is there in his life. If we associate with such people, then one can hear of his powerful activities. Nija virya vaibhavam, that is the potential activities of the Lord. They have got so much potency. So one can hear of the powerful activities and soon come to understand them. The activities of Mukunda are so potent that simply by hearing of them, one immediately associates with the Lord. So actually what happens is, this is exactly what happens. Immediately you can feel the presence of the Lord. When we hear from pure devotees, immediately you can feel the presence of the Lord. So, the activities of Mukunda are so potent, simply by hearing of them, one immediately associates with the Lord. For a person who constantly and very eagerly hears narration of the Lord's powerful activities. So, two things. Constantly and eagerly. It's like we say, Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya. It's not a question of little bit here and there we hear. Actually, we have to practice to always hear. Isn't it? So, for those who constantly and very eagerly hear narrations of Lord's powerful activities, then what happens? The absolute truth, personality of Godhead, in the form of sound vibration, enters within his heart and cleanses it of all contamination. Harati ajo antaha shruti bhir gato angajan. The Lord, in the form of, how does actually, what happens, how our heart becomes free from those contamination by hearing Krishna Katha? Sometime we will be wondering how it happens actually. So what happens is, when we are hearing Krishna Katha, we are actually associating with the Lord. How are you associating with the Lord? In which form? In the form of Shabda, pure Shabda, right? So the Lord in the form of pure Shabda enters into the core of our heart. That means even though attentively and constantly when we hear, the Lord in the form of Shabda enters into our heart. And then after entering into our heart, the Lord cleanses our heart. See? That is why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is saying, what is the philosophy behind Cheto Darpana Marjanam? Right? When we hear Sankirtana, when we chant the holy name of the Lord, and when we hear, the Lord in the form of Shabda enters into the core of our heart and nullifies all kinds of dirty things, cleanses away all kinds of dirty things from the heart. And then it is compared. On the other hand, although bathing in the Ganges diminishes bodily contaminations and infection, no doubt our body, our mind will become purified by taking bath in river Ganges. This process and the process of visiting holy place can cleanse the heart only after a long time. Tirtham muhuhu samsparshatam. Many times you have to go, many times you have to visit after a long time of association and touching or taking bath in river Ganga, there is a possibility that gradually our heart will become purified. Therefore, who is the sane man who will not associate with devotees to quickly perfect his life? So who is a sane man who will not associate with devotees? Why? Because in association of devotees, he can hear the narrations, Amala Katha. And by that, his life will become quickly purified. So important. That is why we are seeing Shonaka Rishi is so excited. And he wants to know, what did they discuss? What are the different Krishna Katha? You know, there must have arisen a lot of potent Krishna Katha pastime. So please narrate to them, because they are like river Ganga which will purify. In 7th chapter in Bhagavad Gita, in the very first verse, Krishna stresses about the importance of hearing. Prabhupada in today's purport points out three important things. What does Prabhupada point out? These three are on the absolute platform. Mantapa. Ram Gopal. Anyone who heard purport? One is the river Ganga. Another is the word spoken by the Lord, and the word spoken about the Lord. All three of them are on transcendental platform. Prabhupada is saying, one is the perspiration of the Lord. River Ganga is nothing but the perspiration which comes out from the transcendental body of the Lord. It is nothing but the casual ocean which is there, which comes out from the perspiration, and later on it comes in the material world. Bhagavad Gita is the direct word spoken by the Lord from His lotus mouth. That is also on the absolute platform. Something which emanates from the lotus feet of the Lord after the Lord perspire in the form of causal ocean, and later on in the form of Lord Vamana, when the Lord pierced this covering of the material universe. So this causal ocean, it flew, you know, it came down to this material world in the form of river Ganga. So it has emanated from the perspiration and then later touched the lotus feet of the Lord. So we say it is from the lotus feet of the Lord. Then Bhagavad Gita is from the lotus mouth of the Lord. And Bhagavatam is from the lotus mouth of pure devotees of the Lord. Right? They are the activities of the Supreme Lord. All of them are on transcendental platform, which is very important. And in today's conversation also we were reading in 11th chapter, after the 10th chapter, in the 11th chapter nearly at the end, Arjuna is saying that, my dear Lord, after hearing your words, all my illusion is dispelled now. You see? This is the effect of the words which are spoken by the Lord. Our dirty things, our illusion, everything will be vanished. Correct? So, in 7th chapter, the Lord explains about the importance of hearing from Him directly. So the Lord says, Shri Bhagavan Uvacha, Maya Sakta Mana Partha Yogam Yunjan Madashrayaha Asamshayam Samagram Mam Yatha Gnasyasi Tat Shrunu. So Prabhupada translates, now hear, O son of Pratha, how by practicing yoga in full consciousness of me. So now Krishna is going to speak about the confidential knowledge by which one can be conscious of the Lord always. By practicing yoga in full consciousness of the Lord. And how mind attached to the Lord, then one can know Him fully without a doubt. See? So, in this, Prabhupada explains about how one should understand Krishna. In the purport, Prabhupada is explaining this. What is the meaning of Yatha Gnasyasi Tat Shrunu? So, Prabhupada is saying, the Lord says to Arjuna, Tat Shrunu, hear from me. No one can be a greater authority than Krishna. And therefore, by hearing from Him, one receives the greatest opportunity for progress in Krishna consciousness. One has therefore to learn from Krishna directly or from a pure devotee of Krishna. So either as the Lord is saying, Yatha Gnasyasi Mat Shrunu, and later Krishna is telling Arjuna, now give this knowledge to others. Right? Now give this knowledge to others. And previous to this also the Lord had explained the same knowledge which I gave, it came down in parampara. So there is no difference. The knowledge spoken directly by the Lord or the knowledge coming about the Lord in parampara, no difference. They're all completely on absolute platform. So, Prabhupada is saying this process is explained just like Krishna is explaining here. It is similarly explained in Srimad Bhagavatam. How this acts. How a person becomes completely filled with Krishna consciousness just by hearing about Krishna. So then Prabhupada says, what does it mean? Shrinvatam swakatha krishna punya shravana kirtanah hridantastohiya badrani vidunoti suhrutsutam. To hear about Krishna from Vedic literature or to hear from Him directly through the Bhagavad Gita is itself righteous activity. This is very important. Prabhupada is translating, what is this swakatha krishna? Swakatha Krishna is the words directly spoken by the Lord or the words which are spoken about the Lord. Both are Swakatha, both are Krishna Katha. There is no difference. Not only what Krishna has spoken, anything which is spoken about the Lord, that is also Krishna Katha. And for one who hears about Lord Krishna, the Lord who is dwelling in everyone's heart acts as the best wishing friend and purifies the devotee who constantly engages in hearing of Him. Then what happens? Next step, after the Lord purifies his heart like this, then the devotee actually regularly hears about the Lord. Nashta prayeshu abhadreshu nityam bhagavata sevaya. Bhagavati uttama shlokher bhaktir bhavati naishtaki. And then after, when the devotee regularly hears about Krishna Katha, then in the form of very, very, you know, completely it is established in a scientific way. The bhakti of the Lord is established in his heart as naishtaki, which cannot be destroyed, which cannot be disturbed anymore. See? So Prabhupada translates, in this way, devotee naturally develops his dormant transcendental knowledge. As he hears more about Krishna from Bhagavatam and from the devotees, he becomes fixed in devotional service of the Lord. So, he has become now fixed in the devotional service of the Lord. Then what happens? When the devotee has now become fixed in the devotional service of the Lord, Rajo Guna and Tamo Guna no more give trouble to him. He is now become situated in the mode of goodness. Tada rajastamo bhava kama lobha dayascha ye chete etir anavidham sthitam sattve prasidati. So how do you understand? Devotee is never morose anymore. It's always jubilant. It's always happy. It is a sign of a devotee who has heard Krishna Katha regularly. So if we are not jubilant, if we are very morose in our life, this problem, that problem, all those things, that means actually we are not hearing Krishna Katha regularly, properly. Otherwise, see, all these effects should happen. We should always think, when we are practicing Krishna consciousness, these things should happen. Then heart should become purified. And once heart has become purified, bhakti of Krishna should be established as naishtaki. That means completely unshakable bhakti, right? And then the modes of, lower modes of nature, their influence are completely gone, and one becomes situated in sattva guna. And then what happens? When he has become now situated in sattva guna and he is always happy, evam prasanna manaso bhagavat bhakti yogatah bhagavat tattva vignana mukta sangasya jayate. Bhagavat tattva vignanam, one gains scientific knowledge about the Supreme Lord. It is no more theoretical knowledge. It's a practical realization which a devotee gets. Once he gets this practical realization, mukta sangasya jayate, he has become completely free from all kind of sangha of this material world. Then vidyate hridaya grantis chidyante sarva samshayah shiyante chasya karmani drishta evatmanishvare. All his hridaya grantis are pierced, cut completely. All his samshayas, whatever doubts he had in his mind, everything is finished. All his different kinds of fruitive activities or results of activities, everything is terminated now. And drishta evat manishvare, he sees the Supreme Lord face to face. So, thus bhakti yoga severs the hard knot of natural material affection and enables one to come to the stage of asamshayam samagram, understanding of Supreme Truth, Personality of Godhead. Therefore, only by hearing from Krishna or from his devotees in Krishna consciousness, one can understand the signs of Krishna. So this is the beautiful potency of hearing Krishna Katha regularly, attentively and constantly. So we'll stop with this. Granthra Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai. Jagat Guru Srila Prabhupada ki jai.